Hello guys and welcome back to Excelsior Academy. So today I'm going to take the lecture 3 of plant tissue culture and the techniques. So in this we are going to talk about the aseptic condition. So what does it mean? It means we are going to discuss what are the precautions we need to take in order to carry out the plant tissue culture. Like aapko kaise sabdhaniya baratni hai, you need to keep your environment contamination free. So what are those ways, the procedures which you need to use or need to keep in your mind so that you can carry out aseptically your plant tissue culture. Okay, so let's start. So the first thing is the plant materials. So here your plant materials can be anything, like as we have discussed, it can be any tissue. Okay, aap ye leaves ho sakte hain, flowers ho sakte hain, internodes, stem, roots, shoots, it can be anything. Okay, then equipments, whatever you are going to use, and the media, the room should be free from the microorganisms. Okay, now this already we have discussed that it needs to be free from all the microbes and the viral contamination. Otherwise, there is no point in doing or carrying out your plant tissue culture. So what are the methods we use? Dry heat, wet heat, ultrafiltration, and the chemicals are used for the sterilization process. Now, what kind of chemicals are used? Now we are going to discuss those. And this is what something you need to remember also, because this comes for 1 mark questions. Okay, so this you need to remember. And yeah, so surface sterilization of plant materials such as seed, fruit, stem, leaf, etc. by the agents like 9 to 10% calcium hypochlorite for 5 to 30 minutes. Now here the question should come: whenever we talk about sterilization, mainly people go for the boiling methods. Now why can't we do surface sterilization of the plant materials by boiling method? So this can be your interview question also. So what will be the answer over here? Then of course, see, if you use boiling method, actually what will happen to the plant materials? It will die, right? Because at the boiling temperature, the cell is not going to survive. It will die. So after that, after boiling, if the cells are dead, there is no point in carrying out the experiment, right? Because they cannot propagate then. They cannot regenerate into a new whole plant. So that's why you don't use boiling techniques for the sterilization of the plant materials. So we use surface sterilization. So ye kaise karte hain? So you take a small piece of the plantlet, okay? Petri dish mein rakho usko, aise rakho. Then with the help of those like calcium hypochlorite or sodium hypochlorite, you just, with the help of the brush, you actually sterilize it, okay? And then wash it with the deionized water. Now what is deionized water? That's the double distilled water, okay? So that you will get, wash it with that so that you can remove this calcium hypochlorite, because even that we don't want during our experiment. So then wash it with that. Then you keep and make small pieces and put into the test tubes. So these test tubes will have your media. Now what media we are using in plant tissue culture? It is your Murashi Scoop media, the MS media, okay? Don't forget, and please keep watching all these videos so that you can remember and you can also revise for your exams, upcoming exam. Okay, so the first thing what is given is 9 to 10% of calcium hypochlorite. Then 2% of sodium hypochlorite solution, again for 5 to 30 minutes. Now this 5 to 30 minutes vary, okay? If it is a flower or very delicate plant tissue you are taking, then keep it for 5 to 20 minutes. If you're using roots or stems, internodes you're using, then keep it for longer time. Okay, so that's how you understand like what kind of material or what kind of tissue needs the time of sterilization incubation. Okay. The materials need to be washed thoroughly in double distilled water after sterilizing in these solutions. Now this is why it is important, because you need to remove the presence of sodium hypochlorite and calcium hypochlorite from your surface of the plant tissue. Otherwise, it is going to interfere in the upcoming steps of the plant tissue culture. Okay. Yeah. Now, then the next are 10 to 12% of hydrogen peroxide solution, again for 5-15 minutes. Or you can use 1 to 2% of bromine water for 2 to 10 minutes, or 1% solution of chlorine water. Mercury chloride, silver nitrate, or antibiotics can also be used. Absolute alcohol is used for hard tissues. Okay. So all these chemicals are meant for the sterilization of your plant materials. Now, basically, like what I remember from my experiences, that I have used sodium hypochlorite. Okay, and the others like mercury chloride and silver nitrate, since they were toxic, and if you're not handling properly, so you might get the poisoning. So that's why it was avoided. And as far as I remember my experience, like when I was doing plant tissue culture, so I have used sodium hypochlorite. Okay, now if suppose you're not sure that you're good at your practicals, okay, but yes, you need to do the research. See, there are people who, you know, they're very much interested to do research, but they're not good in handling these stuffs. So what they can do is there are many chances that they will get the contamination. So what they do is every time in all the media, in all the chemicals, they use antibiotics in order to avoid the contamination chances. So even that you can do, okay? So this is just one an idea. If suppose you think that you are a little lousy in your experiment, so what you can do is just add antibiotics in all your media and chemicals. Then dry heat method. So this also we have discussed in the previous lecture that you can use hot air oven, and especially it is used for the drying the equipments. Okay. Then how do you sterilize your equipment? So you have got big equipments. You know, everything cannot be put inside the autoclave. Now how you can do that? So for that we use chromic acids. We use chromic acid sulfuric acid mixture, or HCl nitric acid, or the strong detergent solution alcohol. Incubator, autoclave, etc. are used for this purpose. So as far as I remember in my practical days, we were using alcohol. Okay. So whenever you want to sterilize any hard substance, okay, any equipments are there. So what we do is we basically use 70% alcohol. Okay. So you know how to prepare 70% alcohol. So you add 70 ml of your ethanol plus 30 ml of water, okay? And this water needs to be a double distilled water. So this is how you prepare your 70% alcohol, and whenever you start your plant tissue culture or any tissue culture technique, you need to sterilize it, okay? And before sterilizing also, you need to sterilize your hand also. So don't worry guys, I'm gonna show you video also, and when the video is playing, I'll explain what exactly is happening. So it will be very clear. So maybe in this lecture, the other lecture, I might be sharing the video so that you can, you know, understand like what all I've been teaching in the lectures. So you can correlate with the lectures what all I have been teaching with that video. So next what we have is wet heat method. So this is nothing but your autoclave. So we can use it for glassware, culture media, and it is always the standard 121 degree Celsius, 15 lb pressure for 15 minutes. Okay. So this is also you need to remember, because this is constant wherever you go, either in India, Europe or US, in any country you go, this is the standard. Then ultra filtration is used for sterilization of liquid media, which are unstable at high temperature. Now what happens is like, there are many, many components of the media which cannot be, you know, boiled at 121 degree Celsius. They might rupture or get destroyed. So such media components need to be sterilized using ultrafiltration. Now how this is being done is that you need, you get a membrane actually, okay? A very thin membrane you get, and that membrane is like, either you get a membrane like this or you get a device like this, something like this. Okay, now this device, inside this device you have got the membrane. Here the membrane is there. So what you can do is, from the top with the help of the syringe, okay, with the help of the syringe, you can take the media components, put it over here, and then pass through this. So what will happen? If any bacteria or any contaminants are present, that will be get trapped by this membrane, okay? And whatever you get is the sterilized portion. And now you keep it under the contamination-free area. So this is how you do, that is called ultrafiltration. So basically, we use it for protein sterilization, okay? If suppose that proteins are required for the growth of certain plants, then you go for ultrafiltration. Okay, then the antibiotics. So you know what the role of the antibiotics, it is going to prevent the growth of the bacteria. So you actually use a broad spectrum bacteria, because you need to prevent the growth of both gram positive and gram negative bacteria. So examples are potassium benzyl penicillin, streptomycin, gentamicin, etc. Then chemicals like alcohols are always used for the sterilization in the working area and the instruments. Now, remember one thing over here is that whenever you work, so there are few labs which says that you need to wear the gloves also while working in the hood, laminar airflow. Or there are many people who doesn't want to wear gloves. In either case, whether you're wearing or not, you need to sterilize your hands also. Okay. So if you're wearing gloves, sterilize your gloves. If you're not wearing them, sterilize your hand itself. So what you can do is take your 70% alcohol, rub it like this. Okay. Completely like this. You have to do it. And then with your sterilized hand only, you need to sterilize the entire thing. So whatever the bottles or the inoculating lube, the petri dishes, the laminar airflow, that the area, hood, everything you need to sterilize. And after that only you open the media or do the transferring of the inoculum. So all this has been done. Okay. Once everything has been done, again sterilize it again with the 70% alcohol. Wipe your hand, close the hood, and then it's done. Okay. Then sterilization of the environment. It is done by fumigation method. The inoculation chamber is generally laminar airflow cabinet is widely used. Okay, so fumigation method is like in most of the labs, in order to prevent the contamination in the hood itself, that is like from the outside, if the air is not proper, if your laminar airflow is also not working properly, so the entire room gets fumigated. So it is advisable that your lab should undergo fumigation once in a week. Okay. Yeah. Then comes to the washing and storage facility. So fresh water supply and disposal of wastewater facility should be available, of course. The space of for distilled water, deionized water. So in each research lab, there is a separate room where you get your double distilled water and deionized water. So don't worry about it. Working table, sink and other compartment should be alkali and acid resistant. Of course, because you're going to work with all these chemicals. And of course, the human tendency is that whatever you don't need, that liquid you put into the sink directly, right? You don't think that it is acid, it is going to burn the wash basin also. So that's why in the research lab, the basins are alkali and acid resistant. So whatever the liquid you don't need it, you just pour it over there and just flush it with the water. Now for storage, for dried glassware, separate dustproof cupboards are there? Yes, of course, because see, first of all, you need to wash it. Dry it, it will be covered. Okay. Now, if you keep it like this, what will happen? All the dust from the outside, it will be coming. And then again, it doesn't become sterilized, then, right? It doesn't remain sterilized. Again, you need to wash it and sterilize it. So it's always advisable that one cupboard, you keep it for the dried, sterilized glassware. Then the media preparation room, this is again, it varies. So you know how to measure the powder grams and all. So weighing machine is there. So in few labs, if it is specifically meant for the plant tissue culture, so you will have a media preparation room. So where you will all have the weighing melons, the conical flowers or the test tubes will be there. So you can go and measure your media, prepare with the adding with the water, you can add everything. Okay. So it depends. And after it has been sterilized, and suppose you're not using on that particular day, you, since it is late, you will be doing on the next day. So you can put it into the refrigerator. Okay. Yeah. Then the nutrient media. So the media is again composed of both inorganic and organic. So organic nutrients. So in the case of media, so inorganic nutrients, it will include macronutrients. So this also we have discussed in the previous lecture that I have mentioned about NPK. So that is your nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, and of course the calcium. Okay. And then the micronutrients like boron, copper, iron, zinc and manganese. Now, if you have seen that there are many cases where you see that something called chlorosis is there, that is the yellowing of the leaves, right? Yellowing of leaves are there. Then something called wilting. So all this happens if suppose these macronutrients and micronutrients are not available to the plants. So all these are provided in the media. And then the organic nutrients like vitamins, vitamin B1, 6, 3, 5, etc. Amino acids like arginine, asparagine, carbon source like glucose, maltose, and growth hormones, or otherwise called regulators, are like auxin, cytokinin. So this is for roots, shoots, development. All these phytohormones are required, and they're also called phytohormones. Okay. So we'll study all these and their functions in detail in the upcoming next lectures. The other media substances are like protein hydrolysates are there, yeast extracts are there. Sorry for the mistake over here. It is the extracts. Okay. Then coconut milk is there, solidifying agents, of course, agar, arginate, gelatin, then the iron source, EDTA, antibiotics. So as already mentioned, antibiotic is required to prevent the contamination, okay, bacterial contamination. Then the pH of the media should be in this range. Now, this is very important because If it is less or if it is more, it is not going to support the growth of these plantlets. And that's why it is very important that before autoclaving, you are going to measure the pH of the media. Okay. So it's very important. Keep in mind. Then the transfer room. So it depends like from lab to lab. If it is specifically meant for plant tissue culture, then you will have the transfer room. So along with your laminar hood, there will be a small window from where you keep your, you do your culturing, you transfer the plant tissue, then you transfer it to the other room with that small window. Of course, you need around 2-3 people. You can take the help of your juniors or your project assistants, which are assigned to you. Or else what you can do is you can put into the window, then go to the other room, get it sterilized, and then again go and put into the shells. Okay. Now, how exactly in the culture room it is present? So you must have seen that the culture rooms are there. So many shells are there. Okay. So on these shells, you can put your conical flowers or the bottle flowers onto which you have transferred your plantlets. Okay, and these shells are present in the culture room, which are having a proper controlled temperature, humidity, light, everything is there. Okay, don't worry, I'll be showing a video in the next lecture. So whatever we have discussed till now and in the ongoing lecture, the video will be clear. Okay, so that will be very much clear to you guys how exactly we do in the tissue culture lab. So of course you will have the culture room and incubators. Incubators will have the proper temperature and the humidity. So light source is going to be your tube light, white fluorescent, temperature, humidity, and the air circulation will be there. Okay. Now optimum aeration. Now this is only required if you're using a suspension culture. If you're using a semi-solid media or solid media like using agar or agarose, then you don't need aeration. Only in the case of suspension culture, if you're using, then only it is required. Okay. Only in the case of suspension media. Now, how you're going to do? By placing the culture vessel in the liquid medium on an automatic shaker. And the other is another method is filter bridge method. This is very old method. So people are not using nowadays. So what they do is you have got the shaker and on that holders are there. So onto this, you put your conical flask like this. Okay. And around 150 to 200 RPM, you keep the shaker on. So you can use that. So like this, you know, it will be rotating like in the circular motion. So it will be providing you the aeration. Okay. Then, So one second. Yeah. Then you have these culture vessels are there. So if you have got the conical flask or the test tube, these are plugged with the non-absorbent cotton plug. And on the top of it, you have got the muslin cheesecloth covering. So all this thing is required in order to prevent the entry of the microorganism. That is again the sterilization technique only. Okay. So this is important. And then you need to have an observation recording area where you will have the microscope. Now, why this is required? Because from the naked eye, it is not always possible that you will see the contamination. So it is important that you need microscope also. So what you can do is you can have your sample and under the microscope, you can check whether any kind of contamination or something, you know, if any unnecessary growth is happening. So that can be recorded and observe. Okay. So for that also you need microscope and it has to be, of course, the dust free area, because sometimes this dust might be seen as the microbes and you might get confused whether it's a contamination or the dust. So you need a dust free area and yes, of course the microscope. So that's all for today. Thank you guys for listening. I'm sure I'm trying to make your plant tissue culture interesting. If you like it, please share and subscribe with your friend circle also. If any of the topics which is not clear till now, you can ask me. Don't worry. Entire syllabus will be covered by this month. Okay. So you can write to us on Excelsior Academy, excelsior1228@gmail.com. If any doubts are there, you can put into the comment section also. So thank you guys. Keep watching.